In the 75 history of the NBA, we have seen some of the best players to ever grace an NBA court and have redefined how we love and view the game of basketball. You may know of the LeBrons, the Currys, the MJs, and the Bill Russells of the world, but there are so many other players that have had a similar impact for many other fans of the game we love. Manu Ginobili, the 16-year Argentinian veteran and San Antonio Spurs legend, is among one of the most iconic players the NBA world has ever seen. Arguably the best sixth man of all time and a true pioneer for international basketball, Manu was the catalyst that sparked the San Antonio Spurs dynasty and the influx of international players that have currently dominated the NBA over the past few years. Manu is set to be inducted into the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame in September of 2022, and he's more deserving of that honor from his years of basketball philanthropy and his crafty on-court performance. But many new NBA basketball fans are unfamiliar with the legacy of Ginobili that he left on the game once he retired in 2018. So today, I'm going to highlight the amazing career of Manu Ginobili, breaking down why he is one of one and a legend that should not go underlooked. With that being said, we have to start where it all began, the 1999 NBA Draft. The San Antonio Spurs are coming off winning the 1999 NBA Finals, led by their franchise superstar and Finals MVP Tim Duncan. With the 57th pick, the second to last pick that year, the Spurs would draft the left-handed guard from Bahia Blanca, Argentina, who played in the Italian Second Basketball League. That 21-year-old was Manu Ginobili, a player many scouts didn't expect to amount to anything and was regarded as a Euro stash player the Spurs could hopefully see progress enough to maybe join the team one day. However, Manu wouldn't join the Spurs until the 2002-2003 season. Now, before we get into what made Manu so great in the NBA, I have to mention the awards and accomplishments he received in the years before he reported to the Spurs in 2002. Manu was him in Italy. While playing for Kinder Bologna, a team in Italy, Manu would help his team win the 2001 Italian League Championship, the 2001 and 2002 Italian Cups, the 2001 EuroLeague, and Manu would also win the 2001 EuroLeague Finals MVP, the 2001 and 2002 Italian League MVP, and was a three-time Italian League All-Star. Yeah. Not yet. Now you know Manu wasn't just any random international player, but let's get into what made him the icon of the game. Manu Ginobili, to me, is the best sixth man of all time in NBA history. Now, a lot of times we focus on the players that are always putting up high scoring outputs or players that are always making the highlight play. The sixth man in basketball is an important role on every team, especially championship teams, because these are the guys that may not start or play a super high amount of minutes, but their impact is felt immediately once they enter the game. Manu's impact for the Spurs during his 16 years was felt every time he subbed in or had a reduced role at a time. Ginobili's high IQ allowed him to help the Spurs in facilitating for others, causing turnovers on defense, or even scoring the ball in a crafty manner that became the usual with his playstyle. Looking at the numbers, Manu Ginobili ranks top 10 in points, assists, and steals off the bench in NBA history, which showcases his versatility on the court for San Antonio. Manu in his career would only win one Sixth Man of the Year award in 2008, where he would average a career high in points with 19.5 while adding in 4.5 assists per game and 4.8 rebounds per game, as well as shooting over 40% from three on over 5 attempts per game that year. He would actually make an All-NBA team that year despite coming off the bench. There are other great Sixth Man candidates like Lou Williams, Jamal Crawford, who are much more gifted scorers than Manu Ginobili, and both won 3 Sixth Man of the Year awards in their careers. But besides scoring, Manu separated himself as a player that could do more than one thing to affect his team to win a game. When given the opportunity to start a majority of an NBA season, in those 3 seasons, Manu would become an All-Star in 2 of those years. The man was just a Swiss Army knife for the Spurs that contributed to the dynasty that dominated the Western Conference for years. That leads me to my next point. The Spurs' Big 3 is one of the best trios when we look at success and win percentage during their tenure. Everyone knows of Tim Duncan, the consensus greatest power forward of all time. Tony Parker, the swift, speedy French point guard who was an international icon who made 6 All-Star appearances and won a Finals MVP. And of course, Manu Ginobili, who was a crafty swingman from Argentina. From an outside look, this Big 3 compared to the 80s Lakers with Magic, Kareem, and Worthy, the 90s Bulls with MJ, Pippen, and Rodman, and of course, the present-day Warriors with Steph, Klay, and Draymond aren't that threatening when you look at them. But they host 4 championships between their careers and a 70% win percentage from 2002 to 2016, when all 3 of them played together. Every Big 3 has the one player that has to accept the reduced role. Chris Bosh for the Miami Heat, Ray Allen for the Boston Celtics, Rodman for the Bulls. They don't get the recognition that the other 2 players of the trio may receive, but they are just as important to the team reaching their ultimate goal. Manu filled that role to the T and allowed himself to fill in when needed and overproduce when his number was called. It's no shocker that when Manu joined the team in 2002, the Spurs were going to win the championship the following year. Manu was a piece that at the time felt feeble, but head coach and future legend Greg Popovich knew what they had in San Antonio. 2 years later, in the 2005 NBA Finals, the same year he would earn his first All-Star appearance, Manu showed how important he was to the Spurs' big three, putting up efficient numbers, leading the Spurs in steals, assists, and only scored 12 less points compared to Tim Duncan in that series. Manu, in his prime, was a playoff riser, and his ability to lead the second unit for San Antonio added to the depth the Spurs had throughout the years and reduced the role that Tim Duncan and Tony Parker had to carry for the majority of the games throughout their careers. Lastly, and I think this is what makes Manu Ginobili so special, is what Manu was able to contribute to the international game of basketball for all fans. I've mentioned what Ginobili was able to accomplish before entering the league internationally, and he was phenomenal. As he improved in the NBA, he was a spotlight for international players that were just as good as the players in the USA. The 2004 Olympics are a prime example of Ginobili displaying to the world that he is one of one. In those Olympic Games, he would lead his home country, Argentina, in points and assists, and would win the gold medal, the first country to win the gold medal outside of Team USA in the past 16 years. To add to his legend, Argentina, led by Ginobili, would beat the defending gold medal winners, Team USA, in the semifinal, beating the overwhelming favorites that have the world's best basketball players in the world. Mind you, this was a 57th pick, a Eurostash player with no expectations that dominated the NBA's and primarily the USA's best players on the world's grandest stage. From international play, this success would translate into the NBA game as the world would become familiar with Ginobili and his slick play style. The Eurostep would be popularized due to Manu and his ability to weave through traffic and finish through the lane. Even though he didn't create the move, Manu mastered it and many other players would follow suit and add it to their arsenal. Players like James Harden and Luka Doncic, who are crafty finishers. Manu Ginobili, throughout his career, was silent but a deadly piece that contributed to one of the greatest dynasties of all time. While putting on for his homeland, he was a leader and pioneer for the players that we see today that are not from the USA, but are amongst the best players in the game. I'm glad he'll be remembered for his greatness and legacy, being inducted to the Hall of Fame, and I hope many NBA fans, old and new, respect Manu Ginobili for what he did for the game of basketball. What do you guys think? Let me know your favorite moments of Manu Ginobili's career. This video took a lot of research and time, so I'd appreciate if you left a like on the video as well. Be sure to subscribe and turn that post notification bell on so you never miss a video. Until next time, stay on beat.